Hi guys, welcome to my class. Our topic for today is about rectangles. But before we proceed, I would like to tell you something about Sheikh Zayed. You know very well that he is my idol since before. I am telling you that. And I have read a lot of things about him. I would like to share something about him to you so that you will be inspired also. According to Sheikh Zayed, honesty, devotion, and truthfulness are the basic thrust of leadership. He made a lot of opportunities available to all people, even if you are from here or from other country, by building the infrastructure of the UAE. He presented and gave the best level of living standard here. And there is one thing that can be said for Sheikh Zayed. It is his innate and distinctive characteristic to do great things. Do you know that Sheikh Zayed was the one who renovated the Western Technological Society into a means which is a combination of Islam with modern technology? It is the foundation of Sheikh Zayed that UAE gained so much attraction from all over the world. He is eminently known as one of the world's most open-minded, amicable, with great visions, and a kind-hearted leader. It is Sheikh Zayed who prepared the UAE. That is why it is what it is today. A happy land full of opportunities. According to his many visions, the most important one was the unification of the 7 Emirates into a single federation and transforming it into a modern nation. You see guys, you are always studying honesty, devotion, and truthfulness. You see, according to Sheikh Zayed, it is one of the best and basic thrust of leadership. Now you know it. That is why you are studying honesty. Our main lesson is to recognize and apply the properties of rectangles. A rectangle is a parallelogram with 4 right angles. By definition, a rectangle has the following properties. All 4 angles are right angles. You can see in the diagram that I put a red square in each corner. It symbolizes 90 degrees or right angle. Opposite sides of a rectangle are parallel and congruent. I mark them with a green line. The top and the bottom part of the diagram have the same length and they are parallel. While the left side and the right side are also parallel and congruent, they have the same length also. Opposite angles of a rectangle are congruent. So I mark them with the blue color. The measure of angle M is opposite the measure of angle T. They are congruent. And the measure of angle A is congruent to the measure of angle H. They are also congruent. Consecutive angles of a rectangle are supplementary. I mark them with X degrees and Y degrees. So whenever you are going to add them, it is always equal to 180 degrees. Diagonals of a rectangle always bisect each other. And the diagonals are also congruent. In Theorem 11.13, if a parallelogram is a rectangle, then its diagonals are congruent. So, if MATH is a rectangle, then line segment MT is congruent to line segment AH. Let us work on this example. If line segment BE is 135 cm and line segment BS is 150 cm, find line segment PA. I mark the diagonals with green lines so that you can see which one are congruent. If A parallelogram is a rectangle, therefore the diagonals are congruent. So, line segment BS is congruent to line segment DE. Therefore, BS is equal to DE. That is the definition of congruence. But line segment BS is equal to 150 and it is congruent to line segment PE. Therefore, line segment PE is equal to 150 cm by substitution. If the parallelogram is a rectangle, the diagonal of the rectangle bisect each other, then line segment TA is congruent to line segment AE. Since line segment TE is already given, which is 150 cm, therefore we can add line segment PA plus line segment AE. This is equal to line segment PE. This is segment addition. But we can substitute TA in AE because they are equal. Therefore, TA plus TA is equal to TE. To simplify TA plus TA is equal to TE, we can come up with 2TA is equal to 150. To solve for TA, we are going to divide both sides by 2. We can eliminate 2 and we can come up with TA is equal to 75 cm. What about this example? If BEST is a rectangle, then the measure of angle TBS is equal to 3x plus 5 and the measure of angle BST is equal to 4x plus 6. Find x. Since BEST is a rectangle, therefore we have 4 right angles. So the measure of angle EBT is equal to 90 and the measure of angle EST is also equal to 90. In a rectangle, the alternate interior angles are congruent. So, the measure of angle BSE is congruent to angle TBS. And the measure of angle BSE is equal to the measure of angle TBS. Therefore, by angle addition, angle TBS plus angle BST is equal to 90 degrees. Substituting the given values in the equation, it will become 3x plus 5 plus 4x plus 6 is equal to 90. Combining like terms to solve for the equation, therefore 3x plus 4x and 5 plus 6 is equal to 90. To simplify, it will become 7x plus 11 is equal to 90. To eliminate the 11, we're going to subtract 11 on both sides. It will give us 7x is equal to 79. To solve for x, we're going to divide both sides by 7 to eliminate the 7 on the left side. Therefore, x is equal to 7.18. In Theorem 11.14, if the diagonals of a parallelogram are congruent, then the parallelogram is a rectangle. So, if line segment MT is congruent to line segment AH in a parallelogram MATH, then MATH is a rectangle. Let us work on this example. Explain how you are going to be sure that a parallelogram MATH is a rectangle. The diagram and the values are given. Since the line segment MH is congruent to line segment AP, which is 12.4 cm, and line segment MA is congruent to line segment HT, which is 8.5 cm, that designates that the diagram is a rectangle. Since line segment MT is congruent to line segment HA, and MH is congruent to AT, therefore, parallelogram MATH is a rectangle. Let us try to identify if the diagram on the Cartesian plane is a rectangle. So, quadrilateral BEST has vertices B is minus 4 and 2, T is 2 and minus 2, E is minus 7 and minus 1, and S is minus 1 and minus 5. We are going to determine whether the BEST is a rectangle by using the distance formula. Distance formula is equal to the square root of x2 minus x1 square plus y2 minus y1 square. Let us solve for the line segment BT. Remember, the first number on each ordered pair is x coordinate and the second number is the y coordinate. So, BT is equal to square root of 2 minus minus 4 square plus minus 2 minus 2 square. It will give us a square root of 52. On line segment ES, it will give us a square root of minus 1 minus minus 7 square plus minus 5 minus minus 1 square. And it will give us also square root of 52. So, the two line segments are congruent. On line segment BE, still the same, just substitute the given values on the equation of the distance formula. So, minus 7 minus minus 4 square plus minus 1 minus 2 square, it will give us a square root of 18. And on line segment TS, it is minus 1 minus 2 square plus minus 5 minus minus 2 square. The answer is also square root of 18. Since the opposite side, line segment BT, is congruent to line segment ES, which is equal to square root of 52, and line segment BE is congruent to line segment TS, which is equal to square root of 18, therefore, quadrilateral BEST is a rectangle. To sum it up, always remember Theorem 11.13, if a parallelogram is a rectangle, then its diagonals are congruent. In this case, line segment MT is congruent to line segment AH. And in Theorem 11.14, if a diagonal of a parallelogram are congruent, then the parallelogram is a rectangle. So, if line segment MT is congruent to line segment AH in a quadrilateral MATH, then it is a rectangle. I will never stop reminding you what Sheikh Zayed wrote for us. Education is like a lantern which lights your way in a dark alley. Remember guys, if you find confusion on some part of the lesson, I want you to go back. Revise it again, watch it slowly, carefully, step by step, and I know you will get it. Discover your undefined smartness. Score high in math. Okay, guys? Good luck. God bless.